This is your math gal, Julie Harland. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where all of my videos are organized by topic. All right, we're going to solve this rational inequality on this video. Make sure you already know how to do the nonlinear polynomial inequalities and that you've seen my introduction to solving rational inequalities. So here's our problem, x minus 1 over x squared minus 4 is greater than 0. Now, the first step is to make sure that you have a 0 on one side of the inequality, which I do already have, and that the other side has a single fraction, which I already have. And so the next step would be to factor the numerator and denominator. Now, the numerator can't be factored any further, and so we still just have an x minus 1. You don't have to put it in parentheses, but I'm going to do it so it's obvious that that's a single factor. And the denominator can be factored. It's a difference of two squares. So I have x minus 1 over x plus 2 times x minus 2 greater than 0. Now our critical points come from the factors of the numerator and the denominator. But remember, when we solve the denominator, in other words, we find the values that make the denominator equal to 0, those numbers are not solutions because that would become an undefined fraction. All right, so the critical points, if we just set each of these equal to 0, all the factors, this is x equals 1, x equals negative 2, and x equals positive 2, we automatically know that these are really not solutions. Now what about 1? Will that be a solution? In other words, if I put 1 in for x, does it make this inequality true? It doesn't matter if you're looking at the original inequality or the second one where I factored it. If you put a 1 in for x, your numerator will be 0. Your denominator will not. So you'll have 0 over something, which is 0. 0 is greater than 0, that would be false. Since there's no equal sign there, by the way, this is also not going to be 0. If you want, you could write that down right now. Or you could figure that out later, that since it's strictly greater than, you would put a circle, not a dot. So I want to place these on my x and y axis. I think I'm just going to fill in a whole bunch of places so it looks sort of... All right, so let's say if here's 0, here is negative 2, here is 2, and here is 1, for instance, so we could see the critical points here. All right, so since 1 is not a solution, because remember that would make the numerator 0 and make that false, we need to put a circle on the 1, we need to put a circle on the negative 2, we have to put a circle on the 2. And so those are our critical points. And this shows four different regions, to the left of negative 2, in between negative 2 and 1, in between 1 and 2, and to the right of 2. There's not much space to show this, plugging in some numbers, so I think I'm going to make my graph a little bit bigger. And let's just now say here's negative 2, here's 1, here's 2. I know this is not to scale at all, but we're getting the idea. Later we could do it over putting it to scale. All right, so if we pick a number less than negative 2, and you could test any number you want, so what would happen if I tried, you know, negative 5? So I look at my original problem or the one factored. I like the one factored the best, and we're going to plug in negative 5. And we're going to see whether we get a positive or negative number. We want it to be positive, right? So if we put in negative 5 in the numerator, negative 5 minus 1 is a negative 6, which is a negative number. In the denominator, if I put in negative 5, the first factor, negative 5 plus 2, is negative. The second factor, negative 5 minus 2, is also negative. So I have a negative divided by a negative times a negative. Three negatives is going, when I multiply or divide, is going to give me a negative number. Now let's try something in between negative 2 and 1. All right, 0's in there. I always try 0 if I can. And you could put 0 in this original inequality right here if you want. It's kind of simple. If you put in 0, you get a negative in the numerator, right? And you get a negative in the denominator, which is going to be positive. So if you want to plug it in there, it's actually easy to plug in 0. This will be positive right here. If not, you could still get that it's positive by saying, well, I'm going to plug in 0 into the numerator, so x minus 1, that gives you a negative, right? 0 in the first fraction, that's going to be positive. 0 plus 2 is positive. And 0 in the next one is negative. Notice I'm still going to get a positive, because a negative divided by a positive times negative, two negatives again are still going to give me a positive. Now what about a number between 1 and 2? You can deal with fractions. How about 1 1/2, okay, or 3/2? So in the numerator, if I put in 1 1/2 for x, 1 1/2 minus 1, that's a positive number. If I put 1 1/2 in the denominator, the first factor, 1 1/2 plus 2, that's positive as well. Then I have 1 1/2 minus 2. Okay, that's a negative number. So let's say I got one negative sign, that's going to be negative. And then over to the right of 2, pick any number you want. How about 10? Right, so if I'm putting 10 into the numerator, x minus 1, 10 minus 1 is positive. And 10 plus 2 is 12, which is positive. 10 minus 2 is 8, which is positive. So that's going to be positive. And again, if you want, you could actually put 10 in the original fraction here. 10 minus 1 is positive, and 10 squared minus 4 is also positive. It doesn't really matter. And positive number greater than 0 will still be positive. So there isn't just one way to do this. Now, we want the places where it's greater than 0, so we want where it's positive. So that's the range in between negative 2 and 1 and to the right of 2. And I forgot to plug in my, we were supposed to put circles on these, remember? And none of these were solutions because either they were in the denominator or because I had a strict greater than or less than, they're all going to be circles in that case. Okay, so I want in between here, that's a place where it's positive, and over here. So my solution in interval notation will be in between negative 2 and 1. Union to infinity. And if I wanted to draw this more to scale on a number line, you could do that now. So let's say this is 0 and this is 3 and that's negative 3, for instance. I see that I have solution in between negative 2 and 1. Right here, and from 2 to infinity. And now it looks more to scale. This is your math gal, Julie Harland. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where all of my videos are organized by topic.